Which of our colleagues, oh gosh, which of our colleagues would you nominate to appear in next year's body issue? If the last question was there are all good answers, this question, I don't know if there's any ones, but Pierre, you can pick one.
I'm going with my comrade, Jeff O'Neill. And the biggest reason why, there's so much to see. They couldn't find a hockey stick big enough to protect the girth.
That's right.
So I think it'd be awesome.
Oh, wow.
You got a little, little personal there.
Just a sec, Marv. Let him. Just a second. No, no, I got you. What went through your mind when you put Rust with Crosby and here we go. What went through your mind?
Doc, we've been walking for a long time. I'm hungry. Permanente Brothers right here, a Pittsburgh original. Want to go in?
Sure.
Doc, I used to come in here with a great Scotty Bowman and talk hockey. We should belly up to the bar.
Yeah.
Mike, what are you going to make for us?
Oh, we got a couple of signature sandwiches that we're going to make for you guys. I think we have the Pierre's between the bread.
Between the bread.
But it is right there. Yep, it is. That's a goal. Nice job with the camera work. That's good. That's a graphic replay. It's a fixed camera here. I like it. Okay. Why do you always have to be the doctor of darkness? Give people some credit. There's no person operating that camera. It's screwed into the ceiling. Good job. By the person who attached
the person that screwed the camera.
If they do some work on you, it's a goal for this game. It's 4-4.
The Capstronaut. A Washington Caps fan who wears an astronaut suit to every game.
He thinks he's intimidating the opposition players. He sits right behind the opposition bench. The hardest thing for him is drinking an adult beverage because he can't get it inside of that mask.
Might have a straw.
And the other thing is going to the bathroom.
Might have a straw in there for the drinking portion.
So he might be wearing a Depends.
Nothing wrong with Carey Price's athleticism. I mean, he's a great handler of the puck, and he's very technically sound, and he's a big body presence on all that in goal. But you think about it now. Jose Theodore, Cristobal Huey, they traded Matthew Gagnon. They have Jan Donis, who they signed as an unrestricted free agent coming out of Brown University. This is not a fit for Montreal. They have so many other needs. They are very unproven on defense. They just let go of Patrice Brisebois. They don't have a big body presence down the middle at center. Yes, they have Radek Bonk, who they got in the Gagnon trade. That's a huge price they paid to get Bonk. I don't know about this fit at all for Montreal. They have so many other needs. Well,
congratulations. We'll see you Saturday afternoon in Montreal for game one of the Eastern Conference Final, PK.
Yeah, baby.
Eric Bélanger, Scott Walker, and Alexander Ovechkin somehow in the Capitals top line. I don't think so.
But you look at their center iceman there. You got Backstrom's obviously a world-class center iceman. Yeah. And then you got Brendan Morrison that doesn't, you know, quite always fit that number two hole.
Fleischman's our second center.
Fleischman doesn't play center all the time. No, he doesn't. Steckel does.
Steckel's their fourth line center.
He's gonna fit right in there. I see Fleischman plays more of the wing for them than he does the center iceman.
In the last 2 months, he hasn't.
You guys done yet?
We're gonna check on this. They played in St. Louis. I'll give you the date. They played in St. Louis and he played on the wing. Steckel played center and Fair played the right side.
He's been playing center with Brooks Lake and Eric Fair.
Let's move past that.
Gary Sullivan, we agree on everything. One thing I'd like to see in the 06 season in the Ontario Hockey League, they decided to put a zero tolerance on headshots. If you look at the developmental process in that league, 30 first round picks, Mike, out of the Ontario Hockey League with that zero tolerance on headshots. I want to see the league go more towards that.
You know, they got the rules already to prevent headshots. They've added a couple more that make it even more difficult. But you're not going to baby-proof the league, Pierre. You're trying to baby-proof it again. Good soccer mom Pierre McGuire is now trying to baby-proof it. There's hits to the head all the time. There's going to be hits. If you go down and bend over to get a puck, I got to be responsible for watching out for what I do. That means I got to take the hit. What, punishment-wise, when you're the guy that's making the mistake.
This league, don't buy it. This league needs two things, fans and great players, and I don't want to see great players sitting up in the stands with the fans because then we won't have any
gonna
fans
make
left.
It. Go to commercial if you want, but you're not going to make it baby-proof here. You got to have some men that play the game.
I'm going to talk about a man that won
stop
a gold medal
so
last year,
of
a world championship,
every day,
a Stanley Cup, a Conn Smythe. His name's Jonathan Toews. He's the king of Chicago,
so
Jonathan
Toews.
It's a double DR. Here comes Crosby and Crosby drive, because that's on the same rebound. Perry for Bergeron scores!
double to Ben. And it's a double Dion to start the turnover for Canada so they can get their counterattack.
You behave yourself down there, Pierre. You got Rob Ray standing right next to it.
In the old building that is now a parking lot, Rob Ray and I used to go at it all the time. Verbally, I wasn't dumb enough to challenge him physically.
Well, now he's got you right where he wants you.
That's what he said before the game. It's okay.
Off that and just keep playing and doing my job.
Have fun, Buffalo.
All right, thank you.
Dustin Buffalo.
How's your breath?
It's not good, eh?
No, I meant in terms of conditioning.
Oh. yeah, it's fine. I mean, obviously, it's a fast game out there, and, you know, you just catch your breath and go back after it.
It's been fun watching it. Keep having fun, Phil.
Thanks, eh? What a, I can't believe that.
Wilson, all alone in front. Backhand shot.
Oh my gosh! Unbelievable by Tokarski.
He took that right away. A sure goal.
But he had mentioned Hal Gill's a defenseman with a long stick. Is this a guy that's going to be traded, though?
You're an announcer with a long stick from time to time.
Yeah, big mouth, I guess.
I don't know.
You don't know about Hal Gill?
The hockey in Chicago, Chicago Blackhawks, Stanley Cup champs, really composer. They know they've got to get some urgency.
Castle's right there, Tyler Bozak, and they're having fun. It's about time. Goals are fun.
Giving him a pep talk for the third period.
Thanks for doing this, Pierre. It's true. You know what else is true? It's true that you get better looking every day. I mean, Jesus, Pierre, what are you doing? What's the secret?
Go to the gym like you.
I like it. I like it.
We're in the CBC television studio, and we've got Jay Caulfield of the Penguins, who's not dressed, and Pierre McGuire, super scout, they call him, advanced scout for the Penguins.
Today is a huge goal. It always is. Today, more so than ever. This place is electric. The question is, will eventually get plugged in?
And they don't like you the one, if you went on. So, Bach and Edsel, I hope they like you better.
We'll see. Nash, backhand pass. Oh, fight score! Antoine Vermette ties the game right out.
You want to talk about instant impact and instant offense? You watch this feed by Rick Nash.
I hear you using the word heavy a lot. Is that because of their mobility on the back end?
Well, I mean, that's what the league's about. It's heavy. I don't care if you are heavy. You got to play heavy. And if you don't play heavy, you spend all the time in your own zone. So those big guys just cut off their arms, get in front of them, and hang on, get your hang on to it.
Then Salvador holds, shoots one. He's gone!
Lemieux and crowd loving it. That's Austin Lemieux with the high five.
Tavares backhand towards the goal. Loose puck. Everybody scores! Tie game! Can you believe it?
I can because of the fact that Kulikin iced the puck. And look at the Russian body language now. They're crushed. Tavares had to step up and make a magical play. The crowd loves it. Tavares' magical play.
Schultz, a corker.
This is unbelievable. Now, maybe he didn't keep it out of the net, but the fact that he even touched the puck with his stick. No way, that's unbelievable. That's the save of the year, and it's not even the year yet.
Last night, I was watching the game on NBC Sports Network,
yeah.
And Pierre McGuire was going on about Getzlaf. Did you see that?
Yes, and why would he ask Josh Harding whether he, who is a better athlete? They're both from Regina, Saskatchewan, so that means automatically they know each other. Yeah. But
exactly.
But who would be the better athlete, him or Getzlaf?
Getzlaf, because they were born a year apart in the same city, same small town.
Did that question make any sense?
I didn't get it.
Somebody said he's in the running for the Sabres GM's job.
But then he kept calling Regina a small town.
Stop it, would you?
A small town.
Small town in Regina.
Small town.
Like 200,000 people.
It was really strange. And he was all over this Getzlaf Harding thing and Regina. And then he had the Rough Riders playing out of Saskatoon for a while.
Yeah, he did. Which people in Saskatoon would love.
Price. Well, apparently we got a problem with your microphone. I don't want you getting any closer to me, so get away. let's go to James Tuffy. James?